Monroe County unveiled a new anti-human trafficking task force that will crack down on predators and help victims of sex crimes. 7 Action News reporter Faraz Javid explains how it works.
It's a multi-billion dollar criminal industry that exploits nearly 25 million people around the world. And Sheriff Christopher Swanson of Genesee County says the heinous activity is in everyone's backyard.
They don't see them as human beings. They see them as a means to create income that can reach $200,000 to $250,000 per year.
Monroe County Sheriff Troy Goodenough announced the launch of a new anti-human trafficking task force called Viper to apprehend the perpetrators and protect the innocent.
We owe it to the victims to be their voice, but more importantly, we owe it to them to recover them from the shackles of exploitation and abuse.
Sheriff Goodenough revealed Viper conducted its first operation back on July 21st, apprehending 3 predators, with 2 other operations in August, which resulted in 2 more arrests. One of them, this guy, a 40-year-old handyman from Monroe who jumped into the River Raisin in an attempt to get away. National statistics show that for every sex trafficker taken off the street, 24 victims are saved. Meanwhile, Heidi Wilt, executive director of the Alabaster Gift, an anti-human trafficking center, says one of the best ways to prevent such crimes is for parents to monitor their kids' online activity.
You know, being aware of what your kids are involved in, even going to spend the night somewhere. Do you know the parents? Does your kid have a safe word or a safe code? If they called you, you would just come pick them up immediately or you would call the police.
As for telltale signs, Heidi says parents should look out for changes in their child's behavior and habits, even if they get a tattoo.
Ownership type tattoos, barcode tattoos, and oftentimes these barcodes are literally used to exchange money. So, you know, those types of things would be huge red flags. A young person in school that maybe hasn't had much and all of a sudden they're getting their nails done, they have a new purse, they got all these new things, and what's changed in their life?
Now, Heidi also mentioned that communication is key. Parents really need to be their child's best friend and not to label unusual behavior as a teenage thing. Also, if there is a communication breakdown, then seek help immediately. From Detroit, Faraz Javid, 7 Action News.